Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Franny and today I'm going to start talking about the books that I actually read in 2021. I know, it's about damn time. Since I haven't been filming these past few months and since I haven't been reading all that much, I thought that this year I could maybe try to do recent reads video. Therefore, in this video I will be talking to you about the first 5 books that I read in 2021. First book I read was a graphic novel and it was Long Way Down by Jason Reynolds. This is a graphic novel adaptation of the YA novel in verse that he wrote. I haven't read the YA novel, but I was able to get this graphic novel from the Libby app, so I read it and it was amazing. The main protagonist is Will. He is a black teenager and at the beginning of the story he loses his brother in a gun shooting. So he thinks he knows who it was, so he goes to this person's house and he takes the elevator to reach he didn't see who shot the gun, but he thinks he knows who it was, so he goes to this person's house because he has been taught that he has to get revenge for himself. That's the way to deal with his pain. Don't shed tears and take your revenge. So he goes to this person's house, he takes the elevator, and during the elevator ride, he will be visited by ghosts of people who he knew, who he loved, and who died because of gun shootings. As I've said, I haven't read the novel, I haven't read the text, but I think that this graphic novel was absolutely beautiful. The art captured perfectly the pain and the grief and just the atmosphere, the vibe of the story, and it was a perfect match and I absolutely adored it and I would recommend this book to anyone, especially white people, because these are realities that we are completely ignorant of, as in this is not something that would or could happen to us because we're privileged in that. So I would really recommend this book to anyone. This graphic novel was amazing. It's hard to read, but I really recommend it and I give it 5 stars. Then I read Nick and Charlie by Alice Oseman. This is a novella in the solitaire slash heartstopper world that the author created. And I really, really liked it. I gave it 4 stars. I think it takes place after the Heartstopper graphic novels because the story starts when Nick graduates from high school and Charlie's 1 year younger, so he still has 1 year of high school ahead. Nick is going to college, so for the foreseeable future it's going to be a long distance relationship, and both of them still don't quite know how to deal with that, if they can make it work, if it's just a high school romance or if it's something that could last in the future, and so it's worth investing in it. I really adored it. I love that in this novella, just as it happened in this winter, there were drawings as well as the text, so it's a nice recalling of the graphic novel series of Heartstopper that I love so, so much. And I mean, maybe I'm a little bit biased because their love is so sweet and pure and they want to make it work. They think that the other person is their family, is what they want to be, their future, and it kind of reminded me of me and my girlfriend and the fact that they might have to face, I mean they will face, and we might have to face someday, maybe, a long distance relationship, so it kind of reminded me of us in a way, and they were adorable, and it has a happy ending because it's Alice Oseman and because it's Heartstopper and it has to be cute and sweet, and so I just loved it. In the meantime, I was listening to the audiobook of The Path Made Clear by Oprah Winfrey, Discovering Your Life's Direction and Purpose. I discovered this book thanks to Tiana. She has a BookTube channel and she's amazing. I love, love her vibe. So I will leave it linked in the description down below because if you don't know her, you must go and watch her video. You can pause this one and just go. you can. And in her video, she was saying that she starts every year with a read that can be inspirational, that can set a good tone for the beginning of a new year. So it was just 3 hours long, and I was like, why not? I can do the same. Unfortunately, it was a bit of a miss for me. I think that I gave it 3 stars anyway, so it wasn't all that bad, but I was kind of disappointed because it's basically a collection of interviews with guests that Oprah Winfrey had at her show. So it's something that, you know, already happened, it's in the past, it's just a collection of things that already exist. And each chapter had a different keyword, a different purpose, a different theme, and there was a short introduction, of course, written by Oprah Winfrey, and then these snippets of interviews from the past. Some of them were kind of interesting. There were some interesting insights and nice reflections made from people that I know, that I've heard of, like Stephen Colbert, Trevor Noah, whom I love. But I feel like all these snippets of interviews were just put there. It didn't really flow. It felt like they were just glued together because they had to be there, not because they were connected to one another. Also, and again, that's truly just me because it's a very specific thing that could not sit well with me. It was too much preachy, holier than thou. Too many priests were interviewed, too many talks of God and Jesus Christ and, you know, religion things. And me definitely being a non-Christian person, let's just say that I don't think I was the target for this book. So it's not the book's fault, it's just, this is totally, it's not you, it's me thing, because it was way too preachy for me. And I was like, okay, I got it, we can move on. So it was nice, I gave it 3 stars, but one, I don't think I was the target intended for it, and two, it still felt like it was just a collection of rehashed material instead of something new that was coherent and flowing and natural, so 3 stars. Then I listened to the audiobook of American Royals by Catherine McGee. This is the first book in a duology, I think, and I wanted to listen to this book. I didn't have high hopes, I have to be honest. I knew that it was going to be trash, but I was hoping for a good kind of trash, like Gossip Girl and Pretty Little Liars, that kind of trash, because I listened to The Thousandth Floor trilogy by Catherine McGee 2 years ago, and I really, really loved it. I think it was good, it was addicting, it was funny, and it also dealt with topics such as drug addiction and incest, and there was LGBT representation, and I think it was well done, so she was able to pull it off. It was a good, entertaining, guilty pleasure read for YA contemporary readers, lovers, and I thought that this could be the same. Also, me and my girlfriend had just finished watching Bridgerton, and I was kind of in the mood for, you know, royalty and that kind of stuff, so I was like, why not? Unfortunately, it was a big disappointment. It's set in an alternate reality kind of situation where there's monarchy in the United States instead of democracy, which, okay, that's a discussion for another day. There's monarchy. The king, who is a Washington, has 2 daughters and a son, and the older daughter is supposed to be the heir to the throne. So she has her life planned out for her, basically. She has been raised knowing that she was going to be the heir to the throne. But then she falls in love with the bodyguard, and the other daughter falls in love, I think, with someone else who she's not supposed to fall in love with. And then the son falls in love with a girl who is poor, so she's not royalty material. But all these relationships were just boring. I wasn't invested. I wasn't invested in the characters. All the things that were happening were just unbelievable, even in a fiction kind of sense. They were just, they made no sense. Also, there's that cliche where something happened in the past and the bunch of teenagers are trying to keep it hidden, but you know, it's going to come up to the surface and then they have to deal with that. But it was, again, very boring, and there was some LGBT representation that really pissed me off because it wasn't well done. it was kind of terrible. I'm not gonna listen to the second book, or if there are more, I'm not. So yeah, I give it 2 stars. I'm not gonna keep going on with the series. This was a mess for me. And the last book that I have to talk about is actually a graphic novel that I have here with me, and so I can show you. I'm very happy about that. And it is What We Don't Talk About by Charlotte Christensen. This is about a young interracial couple where Adam, the guy, invites Farah home for the weekend so that she can meet his parents. But when they get there, things go unexpectedly wrong, because Adam's parents start making comments about Farah's looks, her head wraps, how surprised they are, how rare it is that Farah's parents went to university and got an education just because she's from Zimbabwe, or how some African countries have to be grateful to British people for colonizing their territories and realize them, I guess? It is set in the UK. I don't think I said that. At first, Farah doesn't really address the problem because she wants to have a good weekend with her boyfriend and she wants to impress his parents. But then she decides to talk to Adam about it and tell him that, hey, I think your parents might be racist. And Adam doesn't really side with her and tells her that she's overreacting, that she's seeing things that are not there, and that she's probably misunderstanding, misinterpreting what his parents are telling her. It's a very short graphic novel. I loved the art style. I think that it really fits the story. It has very bright colors that also match the mood of the characters and the mood of the story according to where it's going. I really loved the resolution. I think it was very well done. I think it was realistic and it addressed a real problem that interracial couples can face, might have to deal with. I was very curious to read this graphic novel because I am in an interracial relationship, and I think that stories like this can make you more aware of things that you might have to be on the lookout for, of situations that you might find yourself in, or things, feelings that your partner might be going through, and so you need to be aware of it so that you can deal with that together. I really, really liked it. I recommend this graphic novel to everyone, and I give it, of course, 5 stars. This is it for this video. These were the first 5 books that I read. Please let me know in the comments down below if you have read these books, if you would like to. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe, follow me on the social media places if you want. And I'll see you very soon with another recent reads video. Warm hugs!